Hi, I'm Danny. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'll be repairing the wiring on my 2009 Honda Civic. The dealer who I purchased this car from new installed an alarm before I purchased it. Then they tried to upsell me on the alarm. When I declined, they removed the alarm module but left all the cut wires without resealing them. The same dealer did the same thing to my 2007 Honda Element and my other 2009 Civic EX. These were also both purchased new. Recently, this caused problems with the interior lighting on my EX, which is the reason for this video. I'll put a link to that video in the description and at the end of the video. But for now, let's get busy repairing and resealing those wires. So these are the wires that I need to fix today. These connectors need to come off. Then I'll inspect the wires to make sure they're not damaged. If they're not damaged, I'll use some liquid electrical tape to fix it. If they are damaged, I'll resolder them and put some heat shrink on there. And then up here, these are a dash cam wires. I'll go ahead and clean all this up to make it look good again. And then if I come over here, so some more connectors that need to come off and get inspected. And if you look at this, this is the starter wire here that was cut before, but it's been fixed, heat shrinked, and it's been working good ever since. So let's get started. First thing we're gonna do is attempt to remove all these darn buck connectors. You don't want to come off easy. I'm using just a flat pocket screwdriver. And if you look, that's how they work. There's one. This one. We got to get it from the other end. Right there. I'm just pushing it in. And trying to undo it. There we go. There's two. So far, neither one of those look damaged. But we'll do a closer inspection once we get all this off. All right, that one opened up. Go. And we got two more here. Try not to stab myself. There we go. Blue wire. Now, I have no idea what these wires go to, but they're probably door locks. All right, step one done. Now, I just need to inspect all these wires. I mean, look how tiny this wire is. All right, so they all look good. So let me get this liquid tape and let me seal those up. All right, so I put a bunch of paper towels down. Because this stuff looks like it's really, really messy. This is the liquid tape. And check this out. How messy it is. So let's go ahead and fix them wires. Looks like I'm dripping more on the ground than I get on the wire. And then this one here, But that's okay, as long as I get it sealed. And they say this stuff doesn't last very long, so once you use it, it's going to dry up. So that's why I decided to do my other two cars, because they're going to need the same thing. And I'll get them all done, hopefully today. But yeah, this stuff is very, very messy. So this is another wire. All right, so we got... I mean, it's not that hard of a job. It's messy. And that should do it. Let me just go... gray one I didn't get yet. She was in a generous supply. All right, so these wires are complete. Let's go fix up the other wires. All right, so I finished sealing these wires. There was actually no room in here to film anyway. I just wanted to show you the final outcome. I actually removed this to make it easier. Let me push this aside. And if you look underneath there, this is what we did over in this area. I'll probably put a second coat on there and then put it all back together, but it needs to dry. All right, so it is the next day. I put another coat on all these wires. Everything's back together here. And let me show you the bottom. All right, so here's the wires all resealed. I checked them, none of them were damaged to where I had to resolder them and use heat shrink. And remember all that dash cam wiring, all that's gonna be right behind the kick panel now. That's all cleaned up. And then also these two wires are gonna hook to my fuse box. Not my preferred method, but if you're gonna do it this way, let me show you the correct way to do it. All right, so there's two sides to every fuse. This is the fuse we're working on. So there's the side that comes from the battery to power up the fuse. And then the other side is the circuit side of the fuse. So whenever you hook something in there, you want to be on the circuit side of the fuse, not the battery side. Otherwise, it's not doing any good. So to do that, let me show you how to determine a circuit side from a battery side. Pretty easy. You just come in here and you get on them terminals. And I've got a test light here, so that's the power side. And if I go to the other side of the terminal, I get no test light, so that's the circuit side. And that would be the side you want to go into with your wire. That way it protects the circuit. So once again, if we come down here, I get a light. If I go up here, there's no light. So the way I'm going to do this, it was fuse number 7. I'm going to put it on the circuit side. Take the fuse and just shove it in. You look over here, these are my wires. They're all resealed and repairs. And my dash cam, remember all that wiring that was hanging around here? That's all fixed. And if you're wondering how the kick panel went on, it was just two screws. One's on this side and the other one's on the other side. And this liquid tape, I thought it worked really good. It's the first time I used it. And I hope you learned something in this video. If you did, give me a thumbs up, consider subscribing, and as always, thanks for watching.